Hello, my name is Nuri. I'm doing a PhD degree in Biomaterial Engineering Laboratory of Bio and Brain Engineering Department. Today, I'd like to introduce more in detail based on the last lecture about stem cell in cancer biology. I'm going to give you an overview of glioblastoma and the function of a cancer stem cell related to the glioblastoma on the basis of Professor Kang's lecture, and then explain why mesenchymal stem cell and heterogeneity are important in this lecture. Unfortunately, there are no treatments for glioblastoma now with current medical technologies. Some people who have brain tumor could survive for a long time. In particular, we have to know about WHO grade of glioblastoma to judge how serious it is. Then, what is the WHO grade? It means a criteria which divided of the types of cancer under severity with the microscope. It is hard to tell that this is cancer if a brain tumor belongs to WHO grade 1 and 2, whereas brain tumor belongs to WHO grade 3 and 4 could be considered as a cancer and begin to treat. In here, what you decided the grade of brain tumor is to observe an area where it can generate cancer and decided the grade singing differences of morphology. If we want to study about differences of treatment efficiency among various cancers, we have to know about WHO grade of cancer to compare differences at the same grade. Brain tumor glioblastoma originated from astrocytes, which is one of the glia cells, and glioblastoma is the most common and aggressive malignant primary brain tumor in human bodies. Glioma has different severity depending on their grade. If some people were diagnosed with grade 2 brain tumor, 50% of people of them live for 4 over 5 years, whereas some people were diagnosed with grade 4 brain tumor, their mean survival is just 15 months. Thus, this lecture focuses on the glioblastoma, which is WHO grade 4 brain tumor. The paper published in 2005 showed that combination therapy of radiation and chemotherapy is the best treatment for glioblastoma, and the therapy can extend the survival rate for just 2 months more. Some reports show that 5% of people of them who have glioblastoma can live for 10 years, and anyone doesn't know why they live for a long time. At this moment, I'll give you some clues from now on. I'm going to help you to understand about this topic. I'll explain what stem cell is before introducing cancer stem cell. Firstly, sperm cell fuse with the ovum, which eventually lead to the development of an embryo. As embryo begins to cell division, and it can form blastocyst. Blastocyst consists of trophoblast, blastocyst cavity, and inner cell mass. In other words, individual inner cells indicate embryonic stem cell, which is undifferentiated cells that can differentiate into specialized cells and divide it to produce more stem cell. The most important properties of stem cell can be represented to self-linear and pluripotent, whereas other stem cells are also undifferentiated cells and found through our body's after development. They have two properties such as self-linear like embryonic stem cells and multipotency. What is the cancer stem cell? The cell which have properties of stem cell was isolated in cancer tissue. The cells can replicate themselves and differentiate into different cell type. Their characteristics are very similar to stem cell. However, the most important characteristics of cancer stem cell a tumorigenic potential, which means cancer stem cell make cancer tissue. Some properties of cancer stem cell show similarity like stem cell. Researchers cannot be sure of the presence of cancer, however. The presence of cancer stem cell firstly was found in leukemia. But the main difference between leukemia and solid tumor is that in leukemia, each cell indicated the cancer, whereas in solid tumors, each cell is not important because Burkitt cells, including cancerous cell, macrophage, and stroma cells, are related to form cancer tissue or organ. Leukemia can be explained at single cell level, whereas it is not the case for a solid tumor. For this reason, it is doubtful that the stem cell concept found in leukemia can be applied directly to solid tumor. But some papers show that stem-like cells are isolated in glioma, therefore, concept of cancer stem cell may be applied to cancer. The main differences of stem cell isolated in leukemia or glioblastoma is marker on surface of cancer cell. Because leukemia have specific marker on their surface, whereas solid tumor doesn't have any specific marker on their surface. So it is doubtful to explain of the presence of cancer stem cell is glioblastoma. Some paper showed that stem cell isolated in glioblastoma can be found. However, to confirm stem cell existence, stem-like cells isolated in glioblastoma are cultured in culture dish. If the cell isolated in glioblastoma is right, the cells can be attached on dish in standard cell culture condition, and morphology of the cell in culture condition can be formed like stem cell. After checking their properties, the stem cell markers of the cell were analyzed. However, their morphology like stem cell doesn't perfectly match molecular analysis to identify stem cell marker. So, if the cancer stem-like cell can attach on dish and differentiate it to original cell at the same lineage, we can decide potentially that the cell may be cancer stem cell. Cancer tissue can be made when cancer cells were injected into subcutaneous tissue for in vivo testing. The shape of cancer tissue was formed by cancer cell looks like a beautiful round shape, but this shape is not real. If we injected cancer stem cell into the suitable tissue, the shape is real. There are no boundary line. If we want to get the highest efficiency of drug to treat cancer, we have to use cancer stem cell to make cancer tissue in suitable tissue, not subcutaneous tissue. To definite the properties of cancer stem cell, International Society for Cellular Therapy position statement made a minimum requirement. So we can identify properties of mesenchymal stem cell based on International Society for Cellular Therapy position statement, because mesenchymal stem cell is the most important candidate in glioblastoma. First, mesenchymal stem cell can be attached on the cell culture dish. Second, mesenchymal stem cell have to show positive result of CD73 and CD19 protein, whereas mesenchymal stem cell have to show negative result for CD45, CD34, and CD13 protein. Last year, mesenchymal stem cell have to differentiate it into osteoblast, adipocyte, and chondroblast under certain culture condition. If we want to classify mesenchymal stem cell from other cell, the cell isolated from cancer tissue meet three conditions. In particular, criteria number 1 and 3 is the most important to decide whether stem cell or not, because criteria number 2, phenotype, it is flexible. Why is mesenchymal stems important in this lecture? Glioblastoma is originated from the neuroepithelial cells. Neuroepithelial cells are originated from the ectoderm, whereas mesenchymal stem cell is derived from the mesoderm. What is the common part between glioblastoma and mesenchymal stem cell? Some papers show that protein expression of glioblastoma is very similar to pattern for all protein expression of mesenchymal stem cell. The result I indicated that relationship between glioblastoma and mesenchymal stem cell is very close through analysis of molecular level. Besides, another report show that glioblastoma, which has a similarity with mesenchymal stem cell, is the most aggressive brain tumor. So, mesenchymal stem cell becomes more important, and we can develop new treatment method based on this analysis. In this slide, I will give you some information about heterogeneity. We generally think that heterogeneity means cancer with variety sites have different cancer stem cell. However, heterogeneity is a little bit different in this lecture. Heterogeneity means that different sites of cancer have different cancer stem cell at the same cancer. Therefore, heterogeneity is the most important concept in this lecture. If we want to analyze a stem cell in cancer, we need to get cancer tissue at the same site. To analyze more accurately, we can stain glioblastoma using 5-ALA dye. After staining, glioblastoma can be seen as red color, whereas normal tissue can be seen as blue color. Finally, we can get the cancer tissue at the same site. The properties of this dye cannot penetrate the brain-blood barrier, but if brain-blood barrier is broken, the dye can be penetrated inside the brain and then it can stain glioblastoma. Consequently, protoporphyrin 9 produced by 5-ALA begins to accumulate inside glioblastoma. Brightness of the dye is different with other sites. That means the properties of cancer is different with other sites, and if a surgeon performs the surgery to remove a wide range of the tumor, patients may live for a long time. If some sites which have no tumor might be removed by surgery after identify the site is original tumor, the survival rate of the patient may increase. In this slide, I will give you some information about process to search where tumor's origin is. Neuron stem cell is located in subventricular zone. So there are two hypotheses about generation of tumor. One thing is that normal stem cell becomes cancer stem cell, which can generate tumor, glioblastoma. Another thing is that normal brain cell become cancer cell. One of the cancer cells becomes a cancer stem cell. Which one is the correct answer? I think that two hypotheses may be related to generation of tumor. And if cancer stem cell is the most important to generate tumor, we have to remove the subventricular zone, which has the highest possibility to generate tumor. The three groups can be suggested to search the origin of tumor. One group is 5-ALA positive subventricular zone. Another group is 5-ALA negative subventricular zone or 5-ALA negative cortex. The other group is 5-ALA positive tumor. Through molecular analysis, we can find origin of tumor. Some papers show that if researchers can remove the site assumed to have cancer, they got the result that effect of treatment is increased. Through Professor Kang's lecture, we understood that glioblastoma is the most aggressive tumor in the brain, and there is no way to treat glioblastoma perfectly. I appreciate Professor Kang to make us understand glioblastoma very well. Thank you.